And joining me now is Bracebridge Mayor Graydon Smith. Graydon, thanks very much for taking the time.
Thank you.
Graydon, I heard some great news. The Bracebridge budget seems to be passed, and some good news about, you know, the tax base on it as well. Do you want to give me some of the highlights of what's happening with the budget?
So our budget process is kind of a one-day affair where we really knuckle into the bits and pieces of the business plan and what those numbers mean combined. And I will say staff did a remarkable job in a very difficult time where our revenues have been impacted and service delivery is not easy, of delivering a budget that had a very modest increase to it. I think it was around 2%, roughly speaking, in terms of the levy, which is one of the lowest increases we've seen in quite a few years. It accommodates, you know, everything that we needed to do. We're continuing with our MUCC project. We're continuing to provide the services that people in the community want. But committee took a step at the end of that process to recognize that this has been an exceptional year. It's an exceptional time for people. And we do have a tax stabilization reserve, and we're going to put that to work and make sure that our net levy this year is 0%.
Which is, you know, it's good news for the community. I mean, at this time, especially, there's been some struggles financially. So it's, you know, we've been seeing the theme that towns are trying to keep the cost as low as possible for the residents, which, you know, obviously is what's happening here as well.
You know, it's a balance between providing those services that people need. And I don't think we provide, you know, extraneous services. We're really a reflection of what the community wants and needs, whether it's through our public works department, our planning department, recreation, you know, and the other various services that we provide. But everything has a cost. And of course, municipalities deal with those costs in real time, just like homeowners. Hydro goes up, you know, we have a higher budget for that the next year. We can't run deficits. We don't run deficits. So, you know, we have to get the bills paid and be very frugal and efficient with the money. But at the same time, we recognize that there are just so many people that have been impacted negatively by COVID. You know, this is not a huge gesture, but it's a small gesture, I think, that recognizes the struggle that people have had and respects that, you know, the taxpayers are the ones that pay the bills and foot the bill, and any relief that we can provide, we wanted to make sure we were doing that.
Great. What are some just the highlights of this budget too, and anything that really sticks out to you that you know, you're looking forward to for this year?
Well, I think the major one I referenced very quickly, which is our multi-use community center. We're going ahead with kind of our plan B, which is the arena and the community hall portion of it. It's still a huge project, over $30 million. People know that we're kind of well on our way with that project in terms of the road being extended, which is Salmon Avenue, and the site is cleared and it's ready to go. And we'll see a tender let on that a little bit later on in the spring, and hopefully shovels in the ground in July. So we're working towards a new facility that will be absolutely remarkable, opening in 2023. You know, it will be wonderful for the people in this community that have been incredibly patient in terms of waiting for a new facility. And I think it'll be one of those things that people look at if they're considering moving to a new community and saying, wow, that, you know, that is really something that we want to be a part of. So we're very excited that something that's been 10 years in the planning can be executed this year and accommodated within a budget, even during challenging times.